If you're curious about how did I get from this to this, then take a seat and enjoy the video. Hey guys, welcome back to my second Devlog video. You seem to like the first one, so thanks for all of you, I really appreciate the support. We're getting closer to 100 subs, I hope we can reach it by the end of the year. Thanks for anyone who helps me in this challenge, now on to the video. After the last video, all I was left with is a slow-running, steaming pile of mess. After skipping 3 months, I felt it so empty that I don't even know where to start. I can't just always show the same footages for you, right? So I sat down in desperation caused by my underwhelming performance and started thinking what to do. I had some serious and dedicated talk with my friend about what could be the possible redemption for this game. We literally went through all the possible updates for all of the screens and it gave me such a flow feeling that I started working on the game immediately. So the planning part was done for, I sat down and took a thorough glimpse at my menu screen script. My first thoughts? Who the hell wrote this piece of garbage? The first thing to do was to clean up a little. While doing this, I screwed up the cursor drawing function and it just wouldn't work whatever I did. I was like, why would I torture myself? I wanted to change this. Remember my color changing text tutorial? Well, I've implemented such a method and it turned out amazing. What I was missing from the screen was a nice background. The problem lay within the current method of moving between the menus. I'm operating with an extra surface using the trick of changing transparency. The surface blocks the background image too, that's why it was blank before. 5 sec pause, are you interested in how you can make this effect? Let me know in the comments if you need a tutorial. I might have found a fix for this, but I had a better idea. What if I just forget this method and go for a cool sliding effect? It would add so much motion to the screen. In the meantime, I've rearranged the menus. By default, the main menu loads up in the center. The options are to the right and the credits to the left. When we switch screens, we want the given coordinates to change corresponding to our choice. If we quote-unquote swipe to the left, we decrease the x-coordinates of the screens. If the current one is out of the way, the next one slides in. Otherwise, if we swipe to the right, we increase the coordinates. So, after finding the faulty parts in the code and making the basic idea come to life, I thought it would be nice if the background moved a little as well when switching screens, adding a bit of parallax effect. On the next day, I started working on some improvements, and guess what? I forgot to turn on the recording, yay! The next step was to break the linearity of the moving screens with acceleration. It's pretty easy, we just need another variable to give it some speed. Pro tip, it's better to work during the day. I was doing this at midnight during a Discord call, and look at this. What the hell is this? Anyways, after a lot of debugging, it looked kinda fancy. I thought it's time for some spicy extras to give it the charm, you know. What really catches the eye and maybe makes people say, wow, this looks cool. And what do I mean? A new background. That kind of background that reveals its secrets when moving it. I wanted to recreate the banner of the game to be interactive, some sort of. So I jumped back to Aceprite, played a lot with the designs, the shadows, the placement, so on. And I added the newer designs of the Ratman and the Rat Scout. They look great. So now the screen switching revealed more of the background. Well, not so much since the logo covers a lot. Solution? Make the logo transparent when switching screens. Easy. And now, my friends, have a look at the finish menu. What do you think? How do you like it? Is it better than the last one? I'm eager to know your opinion. And remember, if anything is unclear for you or you need a tutorial, let me know it in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video, leave a like and subscribe to support me in this amazing game making journey. Let's reach that 100 subs by the end of 2021. Thank you for watching, see you next time. Stay safe and take care.